Now joining me, I have Eli Magana, who is a political consultant and strategist who's worked on both sides of the aisle, and he's joining us to speak a little bit about the upcoming election. Eli, how you doing?
Good. It's good to be here.
Yeah, it's great to have you back. I don't think we've talked for, I think the last time we had you on the show was probably about 2 years ago.
Right.
So as far as the upcoming election goes, it's looking more different than I thought it would compared to the last election. Initially, I think the consensus was this was just going to be Trump versus Biden all over again, and the numbers weren't going to shift much. However, if you look at a number of demographics that are traditionally very important to the Democrat Party, like Latinos and working class people and Black people, you're actually seeing slippage on the Democrat side with those numbers. And some of those differences are pretty significant from 2020 and could impact this upcoming election. And I was just curious if you've been paying attention to that and if you have any thoughts about that.
Yeah, I've been following it. And one other aspect that I think is not being talked about enough is young people. You know, if you look at on, TikTok, for example, Trump just recently opened up his account within the last, month or two, and he already has over 3 million followers. And Joe Biden, he's had his account for almost a year, and he has, 350,000 followers. Now, that's not enough to, to say which way an election's going to go. But in a forum like TikTok, you would expect, the Democratic candidate to have a little bit more favorability. And then another thing that I've noticed a lot online is there seems to be a lot more organic support from creators for Trump, which is actually pretty surprising. And so there's a lot of high profile folks that support Biden, but a lot of those are paid activists. So that's another thing that's kind of under the radar. Now, as far as Latinos are going, I think that the biggest problem that Joe Biden has going into this election is the economy. Now, I know a lot of people are trying to say that the economy is going well or it's bouncing back. But, if you're a working class family right now and you're going to the grocery store, you're really feeling the cost of groceries and the cost of gasoline. And I think all of that's going to impact the election.